So one of the main leading bodies of the government of the Confederacy of Independent Systems is the Separatist Council, a council made up of leaders of various major corporations. Today we're going to take a look at some of these major corporations and their contributions to the Separatists. I'm Colin, and this is Sci-Fi Deep Dive. Remember, if you enjoyed this video, to head down below and hit that subscribe button. So we've discussed a couple times in the past the governmental structure of the CIS, the Separatists from the Clone Wars. And as many of us know, the Separatist movement really is a movement for the people of the Outer Rim, areas that were generally sort of neglected by the Galactic Republic. There's a lot more to the Separatist movement and the government of the CIS than this council, but this council played a major role in the military affairs of the Separatists. And, arguably through the wartime existence of the CIS, they were the main governing body for most practical decisions. So let's just jump right in and talk about who exactly is on this council, and what exactly do they do? Well, the Separatist Council is a group of leaders from various sort of industrial partners, mainly large trading corporations and banks. These companies bankrolled the CIS, and more crucially, a lot of them directly supplied military hardware to the war effort. Let's talk about the main one first, the one that a lot of us are familiar with, the Trade Federation. Now, the Trade Federation didn't actually itself ally with the CIS. The Trade Federation's official position on it was always that Newt Gunray had taken sort of a splinter of the company and gone off and joined the CIS, while the majority of the company remained loyal to the Republic. Now, this clearly isn't true. We see the rest of the Trade Federation acting sort of clandestinely in support of the CIS, but it's still worth noting that the entirety of the Trade Federation isn't under the command of Newt Gunray at this time. But Newt Gunray does lead the rather sizable portion of the Trade Federation that is directly under the command of the Separatist government. The Trade Federation, during this period of time, supplied a lot of equipment to the Separatist war effort. This included their large Lucre-Holt-class battleships, a massive number of armored assault tanks, or AATs, a ludicrous number of battle droids and infantry units, as well as a lot of supporting equipment to maintain those huge armies. On top of that, the Trade Federation opened their rather deep pockets to the CIS and the Separatist cause. But they weren't alone. There were other companies that provided equipment as well. The next company we're going to discuss is the Inter-Galactic Banking Clan. The Inter-Galactic Banking Clan, as its name suggests, is a financial institution, and they had several major contributions to the CIS as a whole. Not only did they open their rather large pockets to the CIS, allowing the production of even more war material, but they also provided a large number of Munificent-class frigates which would make up the backbone of the CIS Navy. These frigates were primarily used as relay stations to sort of carry Banking Clan transmissions across the galaxy, but with the outbreak of the war, they were easily weaponized and put to combat use. The next company we're going to discuss is the Techno Union. The Techno Union is a major manufacturing company that is known for manufacturing, you guessed it, war equipment. They brought to the table large factories for producing more droids and war equipment for the conflict, but they also brought a really diverse set of ground vehicles. This includes the tri-droids we see used primarily during the later half of the war, the Persuader tank, also known as the Snail tank, which makes its appearance pretty common throughout the entirety of the conflict, and a lot of other smaller infantry units that would fill very specialized roles. Next up is the Commerce Guild. The Commerce Guild appears to be a collection of smaller businesses that sort of banded together to form one larger financial organization. The largest thing that the Commerce Guild brought to the table, besides, as you could imagine, large amounts of money, was the Recusant-class destroyer. These destroyers would be present in a lot of Separatist fleets and would become more common as the war dragged on. There are two more corporations that we know were directly involved in the alliance that seem to have only had really a monetary contribution to the faction, and maybe some minor supplementary equipment. And those two companies are the Corporate Alliance and the Retail Caucus. Both of those companies were not really certain what they do, and we don't really know what they contributed to the Confederacy. But they still were pledged to the CIS war effort and present on the Separatist Council. Ultimately, the Separatist government, though, is a lot larger than just this council. While this council may have been calling the shots from a very practical standpoint during war, there actually was a civilian government set up within the CIS. It's a fascinatingly complex counterpart to the Republic. And if you would like to learn more about that, I'll leave a link up here to my video on the government of the CIS. And I want you to let me know down in the comments whether you think if the Separatists had won the war, the Council would have handed power over to the civilian government. Or do you think these powerful business leaders would have just maintained power within the CIS? And if you have anything you want to see me cover in Star Wars, leave it down below in the comments. And last but not least, if you enjoyed this video, head down below, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the bell icon so you get notified when I upload new videos. So for Sci-Fi Deep Dive, I'm Colin, and I will see you next time.